didn't spare unto the Lord the words of this song. In the day that the Lord had delivered him out of the hand of all his enemies and out of the hands of Saul. And he said, the Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer. The God of my rock, in him will I trust. He is my shield and the horn of my salvation, my high tower and my refuge, my Savior, thou savest me from violence. I will call on the Lord who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. When the waves of death come passing, the floods of ungodly men made me afraid. The sorrows of hell come pass me about, the snares of death prevented me. In my distress, I called upon the Lord and cried to my God, and he did hear my voice. And out of his temple and my cry did enter into his ears. May God have his blessing for you. May have their seats. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We see here in the scriptures, King David, going down in age, reflecting on the goodness of God in his life. What he had done, what he had accomplished. And he's remembering the mercies of God and how God was with him through all his battles, even when he had to confront King Saul. And he describes God as, you are my rock. You know, and rock being a solid place, a place where you can depend on, a place that is much bigger than you, a place that you can rely on. He said, God, you are my rock. He said, you're my rock. Praise the Lord. He said, Lord, my fortress. Amen. And fortress is a military place.
Strength. Paul speaks of supremacy. Amen. Paul speaks of sovereignty. Paul speaks of the Holy One. God is a holy God. And we must be holy people. We must show the world and reflect His glory. Amen. He goes on to say, I will call on the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. And I looked at his
statement.
David praised God. He worshiped God. Although he knew that God could save him, look at the statement he makes here. He says, I will call on the Lord God. I will call on the Lord who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. You know, and I thank Jesus Christ for coming. And I thank Jesus Christ for dying on the cross for our sins. And He is risen and He's at the right hand of the Father making intercessions for us. When we see that He stands there and say, I died for my child. That's my child. I paid a price for him. Amen. And before he left, he said unto his disciples in Matthew 16:19, I will give you keys for the kingdom. So whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever we lose on earth will be loose in heaven. And as I read the verse of scripture here, David said, I will call on the Lord for his word to be praised. So I shall be saved. This is the key this morning. If we want to be saved from our enemies, we have to call upon the Lord. Amen. We have to call upon the Lord. Amen. So shall we be saved. Amen. And these are the keys that God gives us. And the verse goes on to say, and when the waves of death come past, the floods of the ungodly men made me afraid. And I say, yes, Lord. I say, yes, Lord. I see the waves of death. And as we look at our world today, there is a wave of death.
Come on now.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
And the waves of death is passing through all the world, through all the United States of America, throughout China, down in Brazil, coming up Venezuela. And this wave of death has made its way to our life.
Yes.
Should have done a million. My God. And then I got glad. I got happy. I saw coronavirus in the Bible and I was encouraged. I was encouraged when I saw coronavirus in the Bible because corona was going up against David. And David is a man of God and I was saying, God, what? Corona in the Bible? And I started reading more. And I started reading more because I know God never lost a battle. And if it here, but it get defeated already. So what Lord? What Lord? What Lord?
Come on now.
What Lord? What is the key? What is the key, Lord? What is the key, Lord? And as we read, we go down to 2 Samuel verses 24. And verse 25. 21, 25. And the king of the Lord said unto Aaron, nay, but I will surely buy it of thee at a price. Neither will I offer burnt offerings unto the Lord, my God, that which will cost me nothing. And David bought the threshing floor and the oxen for 50 shekels of silver. And this is it. And this is it here. And David built their altar unto the Lord and offered burnt offerings and peace offerings so that the Lord was entreated for the land and the plague was still of Israel. I say in Jesus. So when I get in the NIV and here we see. And the Lord answered his prayers on behalf of the land and the plague of Israel was stopped.
Oh yeah.
The plague of Israel was stopped. Amen.
Here we are, standing in your presence, Shekinah glory.
Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory, come down. Shekinah glory, come on. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory, come down. Shekinah glory.
Yeah.
should I?